Hi friends, my name is Nandita. I am from Andhra Pradesh. Children, let us see the flow of transport, flow from source to sink. Food, primarily sucrose, is transported by the vascular tissue phloem from a source to a sink. Usually, the source is understood to be that part of the plant which synthesizes the food, that is the leaf and sink. The part that needs or stores the food, but the source of sink may be reversed depending on the season or the plant needs. Sugar stored in roots may be mobilized to become a source of food in the earlier spring when the buds of trees act as sink. They need energy for growth and development of the photosynthetic apparatus. Since the source-sink relationship is variable, the direction of movement in the phloem can be upwards or downwards, that is bidirectional. This contrasts with that of xylem, where the movement is always unidirectional, means that is upwards. Hence, unlike one-way flow of water in transpiration, food in phloem sap can be transported in any required direction so long as there is a source of sugar and a sink able to use, store or remove the sugar. Phloem sap is mainly water and sucrose. But other sugars, hormones and amino acids are also transported and translocated through phloem. Children, let us see the pressure flow or mass flow hypothesis. The accepted mechanism used for the translocation of sugars from sucrose to sink is called pressure flow hypothesis. As glucose is prepared at the source by photosynthesis, it is converted as sucrose. The sugar is then moved in the form of sucrose into the companion cells and then it to be leaving phloem sieve tube cells by active transport. This process of loading at the source of produces a hypertonic condition in the phloem. Water in the adjacent xylem moves into the phloem by osmosis. As osmotic pressure builds up, the phloem sap will move to areas of lower pressure. At the sink, osmotic pressure must be reduced. Again, active transport is necessary to move the sucrose out of the phloem sap and into the cells, which will use the sugar, converting it into energy, starch or cellulose. As sugars are removed, the osmotic pressure decreases and water moves out of the phloem. To summarize, the movement of sugars in the phloem begins at the source, where sugars are loaded into a sieve tube. Loading of the phloem set up a water potential gradient that facilitated the mass of movement into the phloem. Phloem tissues is composed of sieve tube cells which form long columns with holes into their end walls called sieve plates. Cytoplasmic strands pass through the holes in the sieve plates, so forming continuation filaments. As hydrostatic pressure in the sieve tube of phloem increases, the pressure flow begins and the sap moves through the phloem. Meanwhile, at the sink, incoming sugars are actively transported out of the phloem and removed. As a complex carbohydrates, the loss of solute produces a high water potential in the phloem, and a water passes out, returning eventually to xylem. A simple experiment called griddling was used to identify the tissue through which the food is transported. On the trunk of a tree, arising a bark up to a depth of phloem layer can be carefully removed. In the absence of downward movement of food, the portion of the bark above the ring on the stem becomes swollen after a few weeks. This simple experiment shows that phloem is the tissue responsible for translocation of food and the transport takes place in one direction, that is towards the roots. This experiment can be performed by you easily.
Thank you.